What's up, YouTube? Well, this is it. I'm back out of college, and I'm gonna finally start uploading to this channel. I just wanted to make this video to, I guess, explain why I wanted to make this channel, and what you can expect from me, what I'm gonna upload, and what exactly the content is. I had the idea to make this channel about a year ago. I really got into fitness, and I started taking the gym seriously. Looking at guys like Jeff Said, Ziz, Greg Plitt, all those guys with like a really nice physique, and I wanted to do the same. But the one thing I noticed I couldn't find was watching someone really take it from start to finish. All the other YouTube channels I saw, it was guys, you know, close to the finished product, you know, already competing, already like very, very defined muscular aesthetic physiques. So I had it in my mind to make a channel like this where you could follow me from basically nothing from now to hopefully someday being like that. And I've got a little gym experience under my belt, but I'm definitely still a learner. I mean, I'm not an expert in anything from kinesiology to bro science by any standard. So this channel is just gonna basically be vlogs. Maybe some tips, some nutritional stuff, anything I kind of pick up along the way during this journey. And just put that together, make a nice clean video, and upload it a couple times a week, and we'll see how people like them. I should also be including in this video just a physique update so you can see exactly where I'm starting from. I definitely have a little muscle tone and a good base to start from because I've been doing the weights seriously for probably maybe 2 years now with a real eye towards aesthetics. So I'm not starting exactly from scratch, but I'm nowhere near anyone else on YouTube by any standards. So it'll definitely be kind of a journey from start to finish, hopefully. And if you want to follow along, please, you know, subscribe, and there's more to come. All right, well, I'll see you guys in the next clip.
We just got out of watching Vacation. Super funny movie, and Maria and I are gonna head over and get some I think Applebee's, so we'll see you there.
I stayed up just to see all of the faces, you the one next to me.
Alright guys, so we just hit up Applebee's. I'm here with good friend Colby and Maria. And That's gonna call it a night. Go get some sleep. A little bummed that the gym wasn't open today, but we'll hit a chest and try workout tomorrow.
All right, what's up, guys? So it is August 17th. Yeah, August 17th. And I'm heading over to campus now. I'm gonna try to squeeze in the first workout of the semester. We're gonna do chest and tries today. And I hope it goes well. Getting signed up for rugby. Well, not signed up, but checked in because our preseason starts tomorrow. So gym time is going to be limited because we're doing 3 practices a day, and I have no idea how much energy I'll have to, you know, make any more videos in the gym. But I'm going to be definitely doing vlogging and stuff around the practices, just what I'm eating, I guess. How I'm surviving 3 practices a day without dying, but I'm excited. I'm trying to switch up my macros to be a lot more carb dominant for now, just so I have the energy to get through all this. And I'm not being too strict on them because I'm going to be working my butt off all day, so it's really more of a making sure I get enough in rather than limiting anything. The only thing I'm really trying to keep in check right now would be the fats. Try not to eat too much of those. Going for more whole grains, better carbs than fatty foods. That's really my only focus diet-wise right now. And then lifting, I'm just trying to go up in strength. I've always had a weak chest, so I think that's going to be my focus point. My legs are solid. They're not amazing, but they're definitely in my strong point, whereas my chest, you know, my bench is still like 185. So I think I'm gonna start doing a 2-a-day or a 2-a-week split with that. And
hopefully that'll help it grow a little bit, get some more filling in there, you know, fill it out a little bit more. But yeah, so I guess we will see you in the gym.
All right, guys, so here in the gym today, going for a chest and tricep workout. I've really been working on increasing my bench and working on form. So warmed up with about 15 to 20 reps of just the bar. Really trying to focus on good form, pec contraction. And I moved on to 95 pounds. And again, just trying to keep everything tight and keeping my arms in a more perpendicular fashion to the ground. I tend to push forward almost towards my belly button. And you'll see as I go up in weight here, still warming up at around 135, that it is getting better. I start heading more north-south than east-west, but definitely still something I can work on. That and creating a little more of a spring-loaded stance. So my max right now is around 200, so I didn't want to wear myself out too much. I'm doing a strength gaining program of three sets of one rep, 92.5 my max, and then another five sets of three reps at 82.5% of my max. And really just focusing on building that strength. This is my first set at 180, which is my 92.5. Had really good bar speed, felt really well. Second two, I had troubles, as you see there, just pushing the bar way too forward and getting stuck. And I think again on this next one, you'll see my hand start moving too far forward, get stuck. So just working on proper form is my main focus. And then drilling it in here, this is where I could definitely feel how form was helping. And that said, I had good bar speed at 160 now, or 165 now. And the bar speed and the angles were much better. Alright, moving on. I do a kind of an interesting rep set scheme when I do my second movement after my strength movement. It's five sets of 10 reps, and I start with a pretty light weight, and I work up to something that would probably be my 10 rep max. So I started with the 55s, really light, focusing on getting a good contraction, time under tension. And then going up here to 60s again, nothing too heavy at this point, just really focusing on that mind-muscle connection and just keeping everything tight, contracted, and strong in the upper body and the lower back. Right around here we hit 65s, start feeling a little heavy for me. I don't have a super strong chest, so it's definitely my weak point, and I'm working on it. But as you can see, my arms, my wrists, definitely having trouble supporting the weight. And so I think on this next set, I ended up wrapping my wrists for the 70s. And this set honestly was a struggle. This was hard to get through, and it really made me doubt myself on the 75s. This is the third week I've been doing these same weights. My form's been getting better, but I've been constantly failing at around 7 or 8 reps on the 75s. And this week it even on the 70s, it was feeling heavy. Definitely had to struggle through it. But I got the 10 reps on the 70s, not as quickly as usual. But I mean, there you can see 75s last set, trouble even getting it up, but plugging away here. I think I get 9 reps, I'm not sure. I was happy with that. That was more than I had gotten. Definitely gonna keep that weight scheme for probably another week or two until I can really get some good form on those. Moved on to incline dumbbell flies. Really trying to supinate the wrists, like almost to mimic a bicep curl here. I feel like when I really tuck them in and bring my palms towards my face at the top, I get a much nicer squeeze in the pecs, and it almost brings in the lower pec a lot. I think I was using 45 pounds here. Yeah, 45 pound dumbbells, which it's not too shabby. Definitely a heavier weight. A lot of tension on the pecs, and you know, going heavy on flies. I'm just really careful to get good form, and you know, not over exert myself, especially at the bottom of that movement where you can get shoulder impingement, hurt your rotator cuff. So. With these, I try to go heavy, something I'm going to struggle to get 8 reps with, but I also am trying not to be too stupid, don't want to have any unnecessary shoulder injuries. So I finished off chest with some pec flies. And then I think one exercise, then I think a hammer press, or a lower press on a machine. And yeah, with these, chest is pretty beat up, going heavy, so these I go lighter. Really try to just get a nice burn, a nice pump at the end. Really just fatigue the muscle. I stay higher in my rep range, around 12 to 15 for 4 or 5 sets. Just to really exhaust anything left in the muscle. And here another, I'll usually do drop sets on this. So I'll do maybe 2-3 sets of 12, and the last one do a set of 12, drop it 8, drop it 6, drop it 5, all the way down. And really good burn, nice way to finish off the chest. It's also nice and controlled in the machine, so you don't have to worry about injuring yourself or hurting yourself too much. Keep pretty good form on these. And that was it for chest. I think I moved on. Did some triceps. Definitely trying to get stronger in my triceps, so I start with a little 5x5 with overhead dumbbell or overhead barbell or easy curl bar presses. Tricep extensions, that is. And not such a pump with those as it is your body or triceps just feel pretty worn out. After that, I moved on to this little exercise. I'm not sure what to call these. It's an exercise I learned from Mike O'Hearn in his Power Bodybuilding series. And these are great. You feel it a lot on the outer head. And it's they're tough. I only use 20 pound dumbbells. And I only, you know, I keep the sets pretty low. I only do about 3 sets because those will really wear you out. And then to top it all off, some really strict form, or, you know, attempted strict form. Tricep pushdowns, cable pushdowns, whatever you want to call them. Really just focusing on squeezing and trying to use my triceps. And that was it for this workout. Hopefully I'll have some more stuff up for you next week. I think we'll be following a leg routine and maybe some back and buys as well. I might have 2 workouts in the next video. But anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you then. Peace. Like, comment, subscribe. You guys are the best.